Harrison, William Henry Harrison. He was the best president, no comparison. William Henry Harrison, William Henry Harrison. If you don't know who he is, that's embarrassing.
W-double-H, greater than Kennedy's. W-double-H, master of chemistry's. W-double-H, committed felonies, he. Wrote this whole melody,
William Harry Harrison, he was a good lad. He was there for Adam Sandler when he had no fucking dad. Passing all the bills while smoking on his crack. But he wasn't always like this, as a boy he was quite sad. He would talk to ducklings about his hopes and dreams. That one fateful day he'd meet a foreign queen. One that would show him all the things he'd never seen. But something unexpected happens when he was about to sleep. He was hit by a cartoon anvil on his head. 'Twas a miracle that Henry Harrison wasn't dead. He was getting pussy in the hospital bed. He was given Tylenol, took ketamine instead. He was good with the ladies, but best with the bread. He would always play Babin with his best friend Ted. Spent the whole childhood on the run for the feds. By the time he was 6 years old, he was wed. He was just a teen when he caused 9/11. By the age of 14, he was only 7. His mom told him, "You are never getting heaven." William Henry Harrison, her money every second. He missed Rihanna, was sad he couldn't see her. So he invented the Bluetooth speaker. He boiled his dog in front of his science teacher, but he just couldn't bring himself to go and eat her.
William Henry Harrison, William Henry Harrison. He was born in Maryland, God's favorite American. Took a flight to Egypt and he saw the fucking pyramids. William Henry Harrison, William Henry Harrison.
W-double-H, greater than Kennedy's. W-double-H, master of chemistry's. W-double-H, committed felonies, he.
Who the fuck? I don't use Google. I don't know who he is, so I use my crystal ball. All the shit I'm seeing about this dude got me enthralled. Willie Henry Harrison was a master of dark magic. What the deuce? That's fucking crazy. This motherfucker summoned demons on the daily. Hired up a hitman just to kill a bitch named Stacy. But don't be mistaken, the hitman was a demon. Tons of sucky bitches tried to eat up on his semen. Dude who stripped the government for no fucking reason. Throughout his entire presidency, the USA was ruled by hellish creatures straight from the pits of the underworld itself. That shit was crazy. That shit was hell. Any who opposed him would be screaming for help. Honestly, I think it'd be reasonable to assume that this dude was either under control of the devil or he was the devil himself. He kinda had an evil look in his eyes and shit, you feel me? They looked like they belonged to a snake. Life under his rule was supposedly great. Great or not, this dude was a serpent. Can I be sure of this? I can be certain. Fucking on your bitch, and then she was squirting. Fucking on my dick, and that shit hurting. Cast a spell on your bitch like Willie Henry Harrison, bitch.
Greater than Kennedy's. W-double-H, master of chemistry's. W-double-H, committed felonies, he. W-double-H.
Hey, look, now let me tell you about this nigga right here. Nigga, count so many Benjamins, he named a son after them. Like, literally, his name is just Benjamin. Everything he did with elegance. He was smoking on Peck in the Oval Office. Soldiers with bayonets, he knew the top shotters. This man was a god, he ain't need no doctors. I swear to Christ, this man was so fucking awesome. Remember what his mom said about not getting into heaven? So he went up to God, made sure of his ascension. And then God said something like, "Sorry man, I can't do that." Willie spit in his face like, "Yes, you can do that, you fucking idiot." God realized he had no other choice. This is Henry Harrison, he can never disappoint. So as a peace offering, they done rolled up a joint. And then they played tennis and Williams scored all the points. We'll talk about this man to my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandkids. Need to make sure that you niggas understand this. He was right around town and killing all the bandits. Ay, he sailed the seven seas in a motherfucking kayak. With a magical force, he was pulling all the dryads. Way back in the 1800s, he invented life hacks. If you don't fuck with him, you can kiss my ass.
William Henry Harrison, William Henry Harrison. Is there any reason to hate him? No, there isn't. William Henry Harrison, William Henry Harrison. United States of America.
W-double-H, greater than Kennedy's. W-double-H, master of chemistry's. W-double-H, committed felonies, he. W-double-H.
It's me again.
He was shooting Nazis out of a helicopter, got on his phone, Mark Cuban with a number. He said, every Nazi that you kill, I will make a donation to end climate change for every nation. Now on the ground, he was straight gunning them. William H.J.'s killed every last one of them. He knew what he had to do to push it even further. He became a Nazi and then killed himself.
He became a Nazi, then killed himself.
First the number went up to 1,000,000, then to 1,000,000,000, then to 1,000,000,000,000.
Then he came back to life to kill himself again.
Once a Nazi, always a Nazi, even by proxy.
And then Martin Luther King forgave him officially.
And then his VP, Rick Harrison from Pawn Stars, became the King of America, better known as Prime Minister.
That don't seem correct.
Then how about you shut the fuck up?
How about you shut the fuck up first?